Zombies, brain-dead biohazards coming for you and your motor neuron functions. In every zombie movie or book, things are, you know, pretty bad. Zombies are running amok and seem hell-bent on turning every living being into one of them until the world has no more humans left and the grisly infected are ruling. Nobody likes an apocalypse. Netflix and chilling is, you know, just way nicer. Luckily, the world of zombies exists mainly on Netflix and on your screens. But what if it was real life? What if the zombie apocalypse was coming? Hello and welcome back to Life's Biggest Questions, the channel that likes to cover a breadth of topics from science to history, politics to pop culture. We believe all questions are worth answering, especially ones so popular as this. I'm your host Rebecca Felgate, and today I'm asking, what if a zombie apocalypse happened in 7 days? Before we get into this video, I want to ask you guys if you have a zombie apocalypse plan. I know a lot of people do. Let me know yours in the comments section down below. Also, while you're down there, why don't you leave a thumbs up on this video, pretty please? That way we'll know you like this kind of content and we can make even more. Also, while you're down there, if you want to connect with anyone who went into making this video, there are links to our social media in the description box. Okay, zombies, the walking dead. This is impossible, right? It'll never happen. Well, one, that's never gonna stop us playing what if, but two, it's not as impossible as you think. Zombies are infected beings sent a little mad and chaotic. It is possible that a sickness could infect humans, creating a worldwide pandemic. A zombie apocalypse is basically a pandemic with some demonic connotations. We haven't had a pandemic in a good long while, the closest perhaps being the Ebola outbreak. The worst pandemics in recent history were the Spanish flu outbreak in 1918, which infected 500 million and killed up to 50 million people. And of course, if we go further back, the plague of the 1300s absolutely ravaged Europe, Africa, and Asia, killing at least approximately 60% of the population of Europe. The bad news for a zombie pandemic is that humans are living in closer proximity than ever, but the good news is that we're experienced, better educated, and equipped to deal with it. Assuming we knew we had 7 days until the total outbreak of a zombie pandemic, I'm sure that nations would be getting themselves prepared. The key to quelling an outbreak of sickness is hygiene and quarantine. Civilians would be issued guidelines on how to stay safe. They'd be advised to prepare a full-body biohazard suit to best of their abilities. The key to not getting infected is not coming into contact after all. Centers would be set up to try and detain the sick to stop the spread. Borders would be closed to stop the transportation of the sickness, which may well generate chaos and pandemonium as roads become gridlocked with people who are trying to travel. Every zombie movie you have ever watched seems to highlight the importance of food, water, medical supplies, and weaponry, and perhaps for good reason. These will be the things that you need to keep alive. Also important in survival kits would be torches, matches, water purifying tablets, and equipment to make shelters, the kinds of things that you would need to stay alive in the wilderness, which you may very well have to do, but we will get back to that. As people try and get through this, shops and supply stores will get hectic. People will be clambering all over one another to get tinned food, bottled water, and the like. Fights and riots will break out, and there'd be widespread looting. In countries such as the UK, yeah, this will be vicious, but imagine in America where they have guns. A lot of people would be injured in the chaos, so you'd need to be savvy about where you sourced your food and when. We would need to team up and form packs if we wanted a better chance of survival. Cities, despite having more resources to plunder, would be an absolute nightmare in a zombie apocalypse. If you had 7 days advance warning, my advice would be stock up and get out by any means possible. Yes, roads will be jammed, but perhaps it is worth trying to make it out in some kind of apocalypse carpool, or load up bikes and get on out of there. Remote areas with good supplies would be the best option, as would nuclear bunkers, but in those you're pretty trapped. Imagine if an infected person got in. Ugh. It is not totally clear what involvement the military would play in a zombie apocalypse, and perhaps it would vary country by country. Perhaps in more corrupt societies, military involvement would be used to protect members of high society, but to be honest, the more people die, the more zombies there are, the bigger the threat. So it is in the national interest to provide as much protection as possible. If the apocalypse was upon us, world leaders would have emergency meetings as to how to cope with the issue. Maybe in this day and age, we can find a way to round up all of the zombies in one place and nuke them. Isn't nuking them not always the answer? Zombies can't fly, but warplanes can. Sure, the world might become a war zone and civilians might die, but that's just what happens in an apocalypse. You know what zombies can't do either? Swim, or at least they can't swim vast distances. If I had the choice, I'd like to be on a nicely stocked ocean liner and hitting the open seas, sailing away from those infected lands and finding me a nice island to live on peacefully. Coconuts galore. If anyone infected made it on board, toss them in the ocean and be done with them. Although, what if, say, a shark or a killer whale ate that zombie? Would they then become infected? The ocean getaway plan wouldn't be so fun then if all marine life were coming at us. Can animals even be infected? That is a whole different kettle of zombie fish we don't even have time for. One final thought. Say the zombies do get what they want and, despite the unlikelihood, take over the world. What then? Can zombies be sentient? Will they eventually evolve into beings of higher intelligence like humans did from cavemen? Are they just a new breed, a new wave of evolution? Or will they simply run ravage and die out, leaving the Earth uninhabited? If it is just humans that die out, will animals thrive? Who will be the next apex predator? Who will be the next intelligent being? What will life on Earth look like in the next million years? Oof, all this thinking. Actually, you know what? Maybe it's better to be a zombie and just enjoy the simple delights of brain sucking without all this incessant pondering. Although, of course, here at Life's Biggest Questions, we don't think so. Thinking is pretty great. So, to summarize, if we had just 7 days notice, I'm imagining those who already have a good zombie apocalypse plan and are already pretty stocked up would have a better chance of survival. There'd be chaos, carnage, military intervention, and nukes. But you know what? Humans have faced some tough stuff in the past, and in terms of sickness and chaos, do you know what? I think we would find a way to get through it. Many of us may die, but I think humans will eventually thrive. But maybe I'm just forever the optimist. Do let me know what you think would happen if the zombie apocalypse was coming in 7 days in the comments section down below, and what your first move be. What's your plan? I want to read it, so leave us a comment. Also, while you're down there, why don't you like this video and share it with a friend? Thank you guys for tuning into this vid. I'm your host, Rebecca Felgate. I'll catch you in the next one, but until then, stay curious, stay alert, and never ever stop questioning.